गोखले एजुकेशन सोसाइटीज सीसी कमेटी प्रेजेंट्स ऑनलाइन टीचिंग। वेलकम डियर स्टूडेंट्स, प्रेजेंटेशन बाय तृप्ति जाधव, डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ इंग्लिश। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टडी सेक्शन 4.2 टू सर विथ लव, रिटन बाय ईआर ब्रेथवेट। टू सर विथ लव इज एन ऑटोबायोग्राफिकल नॉवल। It's about racial discrimination against black people. The author was the first black teachers in the British school system who went to teach in the notoriously rough East End of London after World War II. He is the central or main idea of the topic. In 1967, the novel was made into a film. Now we'll see about the author. Eustace Edward Ricardo Brathwaite, publishing as E.R. Brathwaite, was a Guyanese-born British-American novelist, writer, teacher, and diplomat, best known for his stories of social conditions and racial discrimination against black people. E.R. Brathwaite, a Guyanese author, diplomat, and former Royal Air Force pilot. He was 104 when he died in the year 2016. He had taught English at Howard University in Washington. Mr. Brathwaite, who became a diplomat and represented Guyana at the United Nations and in Venezuela. He wrote books, many about racism in countries like South Africa and the United States. But he is best known for To Sir With Love in 1959. Introduction of the novel. To Sir With Love is a novel by Brathwaite that recounts Mr. Brathwaite's personal experiences as a teacher in London, where his unorthodox teaching methods won him the affection of students. The book chronicled his efforts as a courtly, Cambridge-educated military veteran who had been denied employment as an engineer because he was black, to motivate a group of unruly adolescents raised in a slum in early 1950s Britain, which was still slowing, recovering from austerity of the warriors. Now we'll go through the characters of the novel. The major characters and the minor characters are given on the page. Children, please go through the characters. We'll see the summary of the topic. To Sir With Love is a novel by Brathwaite that recounts Brathwaite's personal experiences as teacher in London, where his unorthodox teaching methods won him the affection of his students. Brathwaite struggled to find steady work after World War II. Eventually, he gets a job as a teacher in London. Brathwaite's students are semi-literate and largely uninterested in learning. They don't respect Brathwaite, and he struggles to teach them using the official curricula of the school. Finally, Brathwaite decides to switch tactics and engage his students' interest directly. He finally gets through to his students and they come to love him. Students will see the theme of the novel, student-teacher relationship, racism, prejudice. The idea of prejudice is not new to any black man alive. But what strengthens this theme is that Brathwaite also is guilty of reverse prejudice towards some of his students. Another important theme in the novel is the theme of human relationship and the always complicated teacher-student relationship. Meaning of prejudice: a judgment or an opinion formed beforehand or without knowledge or examination of the facts, or to make someone biased. Let's see synopsis of the topic. In this extract, Brathwaite recounts the half-yearly report of the Students' Council, in which the students of the school report to the faculty and other students on what they have been studying thus so far. Each class gives a brief report of their learning through the chosen representative. The lowest class begins first. Mr. Brathwaite's class begins the oldest, was the last one to present. His student speaks about some specific subject. At the end, some kind of ruckus is raised by a student, but then the situation gradually resumes to normal. To Sir With Love is the series or a book of 22 chapters. they have selected chapter number 17. So we'll go through the topic now. I'll give you the explanation of the topic. Children, please open page number 181. The difficult words are given over there. Please go through the difficult words also. The author starts with describing about one of the important day in the calendar of the Greenslade School, which is the half-yearly report given by the Students' Council. Everyone was preparing for their respective roles in a business-like manner, and that was something which the author took pride in. There was no assembly held on that day. The children were dressed in a smart and sophisticated way. Miss Joseph and Denham were the important officials who were allotted the responsibility to ensure whether everyone was doing his or her part properly. The bell rang sharp at 10 a.m. and everybody trooped, which means moved into the auditorium in large numbers. Miss Joseph and Denham, who were the senior-most students, sat one on either side of Mr. Florian. After ensuring that everyone was seated, Mr. Florian addressed the school. He spoke about the aims and policies of the school and how the children can help to achieve them. He praised the children whenever needed, but also reminded that there still is a long way to go before we achieve these goals. Children, please go to the next page. That is 182. Listening to the man, the author realized that Mr. Florian, who was giving a speech, was still related to his school. Afterwards, he wished them success and left with everyone applauding. Mr. Joseph then stood up and gave a brief explanation about the Students' Council purpose. The students would come from the lower classes to the higher ones. Each class had its own representative, which would report about the progress made during the half semester, which began after Easter. Then the teachers would answer to any doubts or queries put by the students. The lower class students were afraid and shy as they were only 12, but then too they managed well. As the classes progressed, the way of presentation got better. The main agenda was that they have learned rather than what they were expected to learn. Then came the turn of the senior most class, which was the narrator's class. He sat up anxiously. Denham read out the name of the representatives. Potter, arithmetic. Sapiano, nature study. Miss Peg and Jackson, geography. Miss Dreyer and Furman, physiography. Miss Dodd, history. Denham, PT. Miss Joseph, domestic science. The narrator was pleased when the ladies were addressed as Miss and was sure that this would be something for the juniors to learn. As their names were called, they stood up and in civilized manner took their respective seats. Miss Joseph spoke about the brotherhood of mankind. They learned through various subjects and how humans are interdependent, irrespective of the race, creed, gender, geographical location, etc. She then called Potter to speak. Please go to the next page now. Potter spoke about the work done on weight and measurements, the relationship between the kilograms and the pounds, the meter and the foot. He said that the other of the two methods were used throughout the world for understanding between different nations, communities and ethnic groups of people. Next came Sapiano, and he spoke about how different things were made, how the countries pulled their knowledge about breeding habits and migration of these pets. Miss Peg and Jackson divided their report, which Jackson spoke first about mineral deposits and the dependency of even a rich country. Miss Peck spoke about human relationship and the post-World War problems, feeding, clothing, shelter, etc. Furman quite surprised everyone when he made a signal and Welch and Allison appeared with a skeleton between them. The school laughed and Furman began speaking in a clear and dramatic voice. He informed that the skeleton was a female. One of that he was unable to say whether she was a Chinese, French, German or Greek. And also if she was a brown or white or a mixture of both. The bottom line was that we all are the same. Miss Dare spoke about the problems which humanity faces regarding sickness and diseases and the advantages of sharing knowledge, advice and providing assistance. Miss Dodd told us about the period of history. The class studied the Reformation in England She went into depth about the struggle of men and how they tried to understand the different cultures in order to eradicate the problems. Please go to the next page. Denham's report was a shocking one. He used criticism for the pattern of PT and games, emphasizing about how less space affected their door play. He went on to say that PT was pointless and same every day, and an actual game would have been far better. To this, the boys cheerful, loudly showing agreement. After the reporting was done, Denham called two children and asked them to write the name of any two teachers, including the head, on a slip of paper. The slips were put in a hat and shuffled, and then were removed one after another. The names that came out were Mr. Watson, Mrs. Drellivance, Miss Phillips Denham, and Miss Joseph led the students to stage and the teachers took seats. The questioning began. The narrator says that it was a rather unforgettable experience. The questions were mostly asked by the two top classes, as the young ones were either too naive or too timid. The teachers were fumbling a lot, and the most calm one, was surprisingly for the narrator, was Miss Euphemia Phillips. She answered the question honestly and would also save her fellow teachers from getting embarrassed. Watson behaved ridiculously when opposed to Denham's blunt criticism and Furnham's skillful and clever way of asking questions. He was completely surprised and got confused as how should be answered. He could not ensure that the PT was any good. Denham, being a trained boxer, was quite sure that these exercises were next to no good and would only help in practice daily. He also stated that PT only twice a week was a waste of time. To this, Miss Philip replied that the school tries to provide the children with each and everything in their best way possible. Though the PT exercises proved to be useless to some boys, it might make a great deal of difference to other less healthy students. She also said that it is beyond everyone's power to please everyone. Moreover, she suggests that the older boys who deem themselves fit could help the ones who barely are. These remarks still couldn't help satisfy Denham's anger, and he reverts by asking that why do the fitter boys have to do it then? Why don't they take only the kids who need it, and the other students could play some better sports like football rather than doing something which is no good? Go to the last page now. This got quite hard to reply to, but Miss Phillips, as always, came up with witty answers. She said that we would take it up as training for the mind as it is of the body. She continued by saying that everything taught in the school is supposed to help the kids live their life. These PT lectures could be taken as a training of doing what we are told, though we may not have anything for it. That shut Denham up, and Miss Phillips smiled. The narrator is left surprised by Miss Phillips' calm way of handling the situation. The morning ended and the heads stood up to appreciate the efforts of all the students. Mr. Brathwaite was happy to see the transformation of the students, and he remembered the days when he was looking for a job in the beginning. He goes through a couple of obstacles before he finally finds a job, and once he goes it at a lower class school where he was to teach Brad students. One, he finally starts to get to know them. He doesn't give up on teaching them what they need to know. Everyone faces obstacles in their life, and somehow they have to overcome it. The lesson we get from the topic is, Brathwaite taught us not to give up on anything and always going for what you believe in. I also think that sir was trying to make the reader realize that when you don't get something in your life, that means you have to try harder until you reach your goal. So all the best, students, and be positive in life. Thank you.